to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 19 in our series, statelesscode.com WordPress. So in our last episode, we were able to prepend the children these empty styling classes, and it's intentionally ugly right now. We'll fix it, but that was a big leap forward. So each of these sections on the sidebar now has what will be in the background hopefully by the end of this episode, kind of offset styling type stuff. So now we need to take what we've got and apply it to our inner blocks here. To our CSS, get rid of this background red. And then so we want to keep the margin Y. So it's specifically, these are the inner containers. I think it's on the outer container that I want to apply these. Let me it's the block group itself that I want to apply these classes to. Alright, let's see where that takes us. So we've got the Z index wrong, but that has us mostly positioned correctly except for the margin and padding. Let me look up Tailwind on the Z index. All right, so I think I might be able to just do Z0 here. Z10 here. See where that gets us. That gets us nowhere. Section.widget. Maybe I've got the wrong class there. WP-block-group. Try it again. Build successful. It's amazing what happens when you use the correct classes. So this is getting close. We need more margin, Y margin on these. For the block group here, go with 8 and see where how that does. Not quite enough. The whole thing. Hold on. Border. No, margin should work here. I just don't understand why it's not. All right, let's make it huge. See what happens. Let's get rid of that class, and then I think I need maybe padding on this inset, more padding. Go back to the status quo there. Let's get it back to like 10. So we definitely do want spacing there. All right. I want more spacing than that. Again, there. So now I just need to get the positioning correct on this back item. Let me play around in the playground to see if I can So that gives us padding there, but it doesn't offset the does nothing. That's because small is all right. So that gives us kind of still this overlap there. Let's move things. Kind of gives me what I want, so let's see where that gets us on our let that compile. I just need like an invisible border. that. I think I can live with that, but let's make it just on the and let's see how much of a disaster our mobile is. It's actually not. I mean, I want the text on these lists to wrap, but other than that, and we need some styling and typography type stuff, but let's so our block group here, we can make this more need the margin y of 8 on this, I don't think. Try 3. So I think it might be the block group here where we're getting the trouble, because these are nested. There are block groups within block groups, and that's so I have an idea on how to solve for this. So let's go back to our app.js. So comments here. So I'm going to add these two classes, sidebar top level and sidebar empty div. So save that. We need to change the inset because both of them are using inset. So that's kind of a misnomer. Got the empty div, and then from our JS we have the sidebar top level. So we'll let that compile and see if that solves our small and up nesting problems. All right, what do we have now? Oh, that broke everything. We still got stateless. I didn't save my JavaScript. Where's the kaboom? There was supposed to be an earth-shattering kaboom. Alright. right, so looks like we've got some problems here. Cannot read properties of undefined. Line 11. Which is okay. All right, I'm going to play around with this in the element child. That's my problem. Now we're back in business. This gives me what I want. Now I can style the text of these items to match what I need. So the headers all right, let me get some Tailwind header text styling classes here. All right, so we'll have font sans for the header. I'm gonna make it a bit bigger than it is right now. Size. Start there with text LG. Apply that. And then in our this, I think we just change here. All right, let's check where we are now. Okay. Wait for the compile to finish on everything else. So I want some like a divider of some sort here. Tailwind. Let's go back to our responsive look here and see if there's anything we want to change at this level. Yeah, I think we want a little bit more padding bottom on those headers. Just happened here. Set of All right, I think I've got the weirdness fixed there. All right, so we're back to being able to see here. So we need to take care of the text wrapping, and we need to take care of the hover. Inside of here, we want here. And we probably want Let's see. Inner container. And using the apply directive. All right, see how that turned out. There we go. That is nice. I think I probably want to make the left padding on the nav here a bit smaller. So it's here. That to 8 and make our also. I should have waited to hit save. We'll add a hover item here as well, but this is going to be gold 100. Oh. Now I've got an error. Created some ambiguity about the apply directive there. Now our build is successful. So we should see. We log out, we get hover action here. All of these give us what we want. We've got a little bit less buffering there on the items. And then the one last thing we have to do is do wrapping for our unordered lists. All right, so I'm going to try the break words class and see if that gives me what I want here. We have now with our super duper long non-breaking path name, it's still super duper long. Thank you. overflow is just going straight off the screen. I think I did something about overflow earlier. All right, let me see if I can do here. See if that does anything. All right. So I think it's going to take a little bit more time, and this video is already running long, but we've made significant progress. Let's commit what we've got. All right, so I got my commit message. We don't have any unsaved. That's just a. That was what I was using for the tests of the Enlighter plugin, so we can get rid of that. And we've got our item pushed.
Want to create your own Ruby gem but don't know where to start? Code along with me on the end-to-end journey of the Nerd Dice project. We'll configure and publish the gem, use GitHub Actions to trigger builds and tests, and create magic methods with Ruby metaprogramming that can roll any number of dice, all while using a test-driven approach. Go to statelesscode.com/nerddicegem to level up.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels, follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.